Studying at Michigan State has been definitely a great experience. I'm a fully fledged Spartan, go green, go white. But this past week has been amazing for me. I've been working with the Ugandan Wildlife Authority, the Giraffe Conservation Foundation, and the Leiden Conservation Foundation to move 20 giraffes across the Nile River. Working with Dr. Julian Fennessy from Giraffe Conservation Foundation, with Dr. Patrick Atimnedi from the Uganda Wildlife Authority, and Tom Leiden from the Leiden Foundation. And without the recap lab at Michigan State University, I wouldn't have this opportunity. Through this time, I've improved my skills in wildlife conservation, and handling animals in the wild has been a very eye-opening experience for me, because I was used to just seeing animals from a car when I was in Tanzania. And now being here, handling animals day in, day out, working with the rangers, has been an incredible experience, seeing the kind of conditions they work in and just seeing the experiences through their own eyes and learning with them has been an incredible experience.
Melman was probably the favorite giraffe to capture. He was very, he fell down almost immediately. The offloading also went well, you know, walked in straight with the bomber, and seems very well adjusted to his surroundings, and now he's being moved to the south side. Yeah, so hopefully he'll have a lot of fun on the south side, which has more lush green vegetation for him.
The pole is coming on the other side. There's a pipe coming. We have two male giraffes and four females. We are moving them to the southern sector of the Nile River right now. Good news, all of them are standing up, which is good. The delay over there was just they were fitting two bars to separate the giraffes so that we can have them in a smaller space so that they don't have to move around much and there's no space for falling down. And everything seems to be going well. We are moving at a much slower speed, which is very good, so that the giraffes don't lose their balance. Now we have about 23, 24 kilometers to get to the ferry, and then you can cross over and release them.
They all look really good right now. Another couple hours of driving and hopefully we can release them and they can enjoy their new home.
These translocations, they need to be science-based translocations.
Right.
So that's why now we are very happy that you people from the university, you can come now to Uganda Wildlife Authority and see what we are doing together. So the data we are collecting through all this, it helps us build those needed, urgently needed baselines for which will serve to be the foundations for the future management of this species.
What one goes, one goes.
Come on, Melman. Don't disappoint. He's almost there. You go. All six out. Great stuff.
I'm super excited. I mean, it's great to have you here, and I hope this is just the start of a long-term partnership and relationship. We as GCF are all about partnering.
Definitely.
And if we can help Africa's giraffe, involving Africans on the ground throughout the continent to save giraffe, we're going to do this together, mate.
Oh, thank you. It's been an incredible experience.
We can't own it from across in the U.S. They have to have ownership. They have to do the work. We could help assist them. We give them financial support, any other support. But unless they have the passion and the gumption to do it, it's not going to happen. And Arthur represents that group of people that could make it happen.
Who will conserve wildlife? Spartans will.